Hi, I'm Dr. Edwin Williams. I'm here to answer your questions about chin augmentation. Can it be done with rhinoplasty? As a rhinoplasty specialist, I'm asked this question all the time. What I usually tell people is that not only can it be done together, it probably should be done together in a patient that it's indicated. For example, in our practice, I would say probably one in every 8 to 10 patients would benefit from a very conservative chin augmentation at the same time that we're reducing the size of the nose. And the real reason why is what it really comes down to is balance. If you're making this nose a little bit bigger and you've got a little bit of a weak chin, bringing the chin out and bringing the nose back a little leaves a much more natural appearance. And so what we try to do is we use computerized imaging as a great communication tool so that we can demonstrate that to the patient. Some patients know that they have a weak chin and others don't. And so it's somewhat of a delicate discussion, but nonetheless a patient's choice. But we will bring it up if a patient asks. What is it made out of? Probably the most common material that's used is silastic. There are a number of different companies and they're safe. I personally have used now for almost 20 years a Gore-Tex covered silastic. And the reason why I like Gore-Tex is you don't form a capsule around it and the body actually ingrows into it a little bit to secure it in place. And I have never had to take one out, which I really like. It's extremely safe. And you can check out some of our photos on our website. But here's what the chin looks like. Now this is blue, but this is basically a mock-up. And what I like about them, you see, is that when they're placed in, and I put them through a small incision here, you literally cannot feel the edges of them. In fact, no one will know by feeling the chin. It feels very, very normal. In fact, it doesn't feel any different than your normal chin would. You can go through the inside of the mouth or you can go through here. I actually like to go here. It's the least invasive. I can get it through a very small incision, and a number of the patients actually benefit a little bit from a little bit of liposuction to improve their profile as well, because their neck is a little blunted. So between, and if you take a look at the photo accompanying this video, you can see that patient had it. Are there any bridges burned if you don't have the chin at the same time? No, you can always do it down the road. Some patients will come in and say, well, you know, financially, I'm not really prepared for that. Or, you know, I want to think about that. And so, in those individuals, they can always have it done down the road. And we do liposuction at the same time. So that's basically it. You know, problems, complications. I think we always talk to people about, you know, with a very experienced rhinoplasty surgeon, complications are remote. I don't think I've ever seen an infection. In fact, I've never had to take one out and put it back. I always tell patients, if you think it's too big or small, I'll take it out and put it back, but I've got a lot of experience doing this. So any of the other frequently asked questions you might have, there's this book we have, Rhinoplasty, Everything You Need to Know About Fixing and Reshaping Your Nose. This is on Amazon, and the proceeds go to domestic violence. So I hope you found this information useful, and good luck in doing your research.